Syracuse finally got a win in the ACC Tournament, 73-64 over Wake Forest. Now the Orange takes on the North Carolina Tar Heels on Wednesday in the second round. Hello, everybody, and welcome inside the CitrusTV studios to another web edition of Cuse Countdown. Alongside AJ Fabbri and Mike Adzima, I'm Jonathon Hoppe. Guys, first question, what does this win mean for Syracuse as a program? First win in a conference tournament since leaving the Big East.
Well, I think this is a big win for the Orange. You consider the talent that Syracuse has put on the ACC Tournament floor in previous years, you wouldn't really expect this group of guys to be the first team to get a win in ACC tournament play for the Orange, but I think this is a big win for this team, especially being on the bubble.
Yeah, definitely a big win for this team, but in terms of the program, Syracuse players, they compete for Final Fours. You're not competing to win first round ACC tournament games against Wake Forest. So it's a step in the right direction, but they got to keep the ball rolling.
Syracuse playing back-to-back games on Wednesday. North Carolina, very well rested. Haven't played since Saturday against Duke. They lost that rivalry game, so you know they're going to be ready for a bounce-back win. Guys, what's the key to Syracuse upsetting North Carolina?
My key for the Orange to get the win in this one is to spread the wealth, distribute the scoring like they did against Wake Forest. Merrick Dolezal had 20 points, Pascal Chukwu 14 points and 9 boards. Not typically guys who see put up those types of numbers. Those two have to continue their great performances into this UNC game. Don't totally rely on the offense to run through Tyus Battle and Frank Howard. Move the ball around, distribute the scoring.
Yeah, I'm still waiting for that Dolezal Chukwu buddy cop movie. But my key to this one is to avoid the scoring droughts. In the first half, Syracuse had a 16-point lead. Then they went 5 minutes without a field goal. That allowed Wake to cut it to 4 points. Then you look at the UNC regular season game. Syracuse went stretches of 7 minutes, 4 minutes without a field goal, and then 3 minutes at the end of regulation where they did not have a bucket. You got to score consistently if you're going to keep pace with the defending champs.
A win over North Carolina would certainly boost Syracuse's tournament resume. So, AJ, does Syracuse get it done on Wednesday?
Listen, big win down in Brooklyn, but I don't think they're going to be able to replicate that success. 82-70 Tar Heels. Listen, Luke May, he was in a lot of foul trouble in the regular season game. He was limited, had to stay on the bench, could not figure it out. But in this game, he's not going to have that foul trouble. He's going to be knocking down mid-range jumpers. He poses a problem for this 2-3 zone. Pascal Chukwu is going to have some trouble getting out there and defending him. I think Luke May is going to have a big game, and I like the Tar Heels to roll in this one.
I agree with you, AJ. I think North Carolina is going to get the win here, 74-68. In that win in the Carrier Dome for UNC, Theo Pinson had 23 points against the Orange. I think that's a key for Syracuse to make sure to D him up and contain him. Tyus Battle, 26 points. Frank Howard, 23 points in that game. Like I said earlier, distribute the scoring. Don't rely so much on those guys. I think the Orange are going to ride some of that momentum from the Wake Forest win, but in the end, it just won't be enough to get over the defending national champs.
All right, both our analysts think Syracuse falls to North Carolina. To find out if that happens, make sure to keep it locked to CitrusTV Sports on Twitter for all the coverage from the Barclays Center. For AJ Fabbri, Mike Adzima, the rest of our great Cuse Countdown crew, I'm Jonathon Hoppe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.